This is our newest animation, and today I break it down for you. We used a technique that involves combining video footage with rendered 3D scenes. One of the most significant benefits of this method is the improvement in visual aesthetics. By integrating video clips with the flexibility of CGI, we can produce vibrant, lifelike outputs. Also, with more creative options, we can influence the viewer by conveying a particular mood, atmosphere, or message more easily. A viewer who is not experienced as a 3D artist cannot tell what is real footage and what is created in 3D, so it enhances the visual level of animation. Our idea was to create a commercial animation for the new course. Commercial animations have their own specifics. They are typically slightly slower with less dynamic type of shots to create relaxed, chilled atmosphere. This type of animation focuses on promoting a specific place, but most importantly, on its experience. For our space, the most important was to show the summer vibe of the location. Our goal was to draw the audience in to feel this holidays mood. At the same time, we didn't want to make it too epic or too slow to avoid creating a fake effect. We wanted to create something large scale, so we decided on a hotel resort by the sea in Spain to prepare you for the most demanding animation projects. With the increasing accessibility of AI tools that allow amateurs to create visualizations, the demand for marketing content will drastically shift from visualizations to animations. On the other hand, the ability to create stunning visualizations still will be crucial, as to create amazing animation, you'll have to have a solid base and animate on top of that. The camera plays a crucial role in creating a visually appealing and impactful output. We can use it to guide our audience. To make our visual experience more realistic, we presented various camera angles that mimic human behavior. In animation, as in real life, we observe things from different positions to more accurately perceive the world around us. We don't use only the cameras at eye level looking straight, but also by looking up or down. Camera movements also play a crucial role in creating emotional impact in films or animation. Different types of camera movements can evoke different emotional reactions from viewers. For instance, consider the first shot of our animation. By choosing an aerial view for the first clip, we establish the location and convey a sense of scale for a height vantage point. We show the context, but the viewer cannot see the place in detail. We approach presenting the space gradually, from presenting the overall view of the resort to more and more detailed shots. The next clips are more static. They slow down the animation for a while and create sort of a pause before the hero shot, where we reveal the actual space to the audience. And this is why we use the tilt camera movement here to reveal the essential details of a scene and to enhance the overall impact of the scene. Also, intentionally, we used an eye level here to keep everything looking normal and create a sense of being there for a viewer. Then again, we use video footage with static camera where only the character is moving to focus on emotions, happiness, joy, and pleasure. And two quick cuts where we even don't see what is going on. It is just a glimpse of close-ups that make animation more dynamic and also spice up emotions. And then again, we used another tracking shot, the palm movement, to follow the characters in the scene, which can make a viewer feel like he's part of the scene. Let me tell you more about the course. We'll teach you everything you need to know about architectural animations. The course is well structured and consists of 10 modules. You will learn the basics of animations to know what is it all about. We'll talk about animated cameras, objects, and aerial animations. We go through the process of creating the animation step by step and video editing. Finally, we show you how to prepare for rendering, how to use AI to speed up the process, and we explain the business side of animations. No matter if you are a total beginner in creating animations or you are in the field for a while, this course is for you. However, to produce high-quality animations, you have to know how to do visualizations first. If you don't feel good at visualizations, don't worry. We've got a bundle that covers both visualization and animation. After this course, you can instantly start landing architectural animation projects. The money you put into the course can be returned even a dozen of times after just one commercial project. From this point of view, the course is really affordable invest in yourself. The use of appropriate lighting can significantly enhance the ambience and mood of any space. In our animation, we showcase a range of different lighting scenarios, starting from the early morning and progressing through the afternoon before finishing at sunset. We aim to provide a gradual and immersive experience that truly captures the beauty of different times of the day in this location. All day shots are sunny and warm to emphasize the great weather and summer mood. Also, the sky is clear or almost clear in most scenes to recreate the holiday vibe. By carefully selecting the lighting, we can highlight positive emotions of happiness, joy, and pleasure, making the place warm and inviting. Also, adding caustics in the swimming pool shots was crucial for creating an effect of the pattern of lights and color that happen when light rays are reflected or refracted from a surface. Movement is what makes still image an animation. For example, here we animated the curtains in Marvelous Designer. In this shot, we animated the car. Not only the car itself is moving, but also the wheels are rotating as in real life. In the bathroom basin shot, we animated the water in the tub with the use of Fenix FD. And the bubbles are made with the use of Tyflo. You might think that the more movement you have in your 3D scene, the more realistic it's gonna be. And that's true. But in commercial animations, you should be able to balance your ambition for creating hyper-realistic animations with budget. Creating moving objects is time-consuming, which translates directly to the price of the shot. For instance, in quick clips, especially with the camera moving, you don't have to animate everything as it's too quick for the eye to see the difference. The first impression is the most important, so animating one or two things might be enough. Here we animated the trees and water, and we also added an animated walking man to add the scale to the space. But in this shot, on another hand, we only animated the water as it's too fast to see anything else. In the lobby shot, for instance, we used only the camera and shadows to add movement. So you can see that we can use various approaches depending on the need. One of the most challenging things in creating animations is always the rendering time. In our case, the whole animation was around 1500 4K renders in total. We chose Helio, which is a cloud rendering service, and we rendered the whole animation there. I highly recommend them as rendering was super fast and smooth. And by the way, this video is not sponsored by them. However, we contacted them and they were kind enough to give all of you $50 in render units and $200 in render units for the students of our animation training. Next, let me break down the first shot. We decided to compose our 3D building into drone footage in order to achieve the highest level of photorealism. This was the most challenging part of the project. The course module about this shot is about 2 hours long, and we showed the whole process step by step. Recording time was way longer though. It was definitely the most complex tutorial we have recorded so far, and unfortunately, we had to do it twice because the screen recording had been deleted by accident. First, we had to track the camera movement of the footage and export it into 3ds Max as a camera. Then we had to adjust the 3D model to match the footage and tracking data. When the camera was tracked, we had to create masks for objects that appeared in front of our buildings and also remove the existing buildings from the site. We intentionally chose this really hard example to prepare you for your future projects. Lastly, we put it all together and matched the colors, so everything looked as real as possible. Talking about editing, I have to start with the music. Music is a very important aspect of creating animation as it makes viewers more emotional and suggests feelings. It becomes sort of the foundation of the video edit. We knew that to match our idea, we needed a melody that would have this summer relaxed vibe. We use a service called Artlist, which has a huge collection of music and sound effects that makes finding the right track really easy. Every shot was produced to match its rhythm. We had to adjust the length of each shot, its speed, the style or camera type. In the beginning, the first drone footage is slow and lasts long, so the viewer has time to understand the location and the context. Then we have shots that have similar lengths. The first two are quite slow to give us a bit of space before the next clip, the hero shot, which is a bit faster. And then, again, similar speed footage. And next, fast cuts. Then again, we slow down. 3D renders and video clips with combination of music influence emotions, and how we perceive the space. Ideally, you will have the budget for directing and recording specific video clips with actors, similarly as we show you in the video we recorded with Motive Studio. However, if you don't have budget for that, you can also use the stock footage, as we did in our case, and look for something that conveys the idea the most. Obviously, it won't be perfect, as you won't find the same characters in all the places you want, but it can be good enough to present the atmosphere and emotions. Other things are the transitions. In all the clips, we used hard cuts, except for two places. The first example is between pull shots, where we wanted the two clips to transition into each other. We use an object moving across a clip, bringing a new scene behind it. It makes animation more interesting, but you should avoid using it too much. And here, we decided to use a soft transition as it matches the music in this place. Except for that, we also color graded all the footage to match the final style and keep a cohesive look. If you want to learn all about animations, join our training. You can also stay here on YouTube and watch more videos like this one. Bye bye!